In linear regression, we are given data, and data has to have more than one dimension. We'll just study it for two dimensions throughout this class. So this might be the data, and we're looking for the best line that fits the data, or put differently, the parameters A and B that we discussed before that defines the line. The word best is interesting. Obviously, it's impossible to put a line through the data points over here. These are what's called nonlinear data. They go up and down. Data often looks like this. Even if the relationship between X and Y is linear, there's usually what's called noise in the data, some amount of randomness we can't explain. So in finding the best fit, we're trying to find a line that minimizes the difference between the data and the line in the Y direction. And that's somewhat counterintuitive. You'd normally think the distance is given by these lines over here in red, and that it's the shortest distance irrespective of X and Y. But in linear regression, it turns out that we're minimizing the distance just in the Y direction. And there's a lot of theory why this is a good idea. In summary, we assume that our data is the result of applying some unknown linear function, Bx plus A, plus noise. And if this noise is assumed to be Gaussian, then minimizing the quadratic deviation between the data points and the line happens to be the correct mathematical answer. But leaving this aside, what we're doing is we are adding over all data points the difference between our function and the Y value of the data point with the square, and that distance is the distance we are minimizing. So let's look into this with examples. With the following four data points, which of these lines has the smallest quadratic error and would be the best regression line? Pick one of the three.